What is going on, YouTube family? Thank you guys again for being here with me today. I always appreciate your time. It's all that we have and it does not exist. In today's video, I just want to talk about the subject, the topic of opening the doors to allow more opportunity to come to you. Opening the gates to allow more blessings, more positive manifestations in your life. I feel like we always want more for ourselves. We want more for the people around us. We could be attached to material things. We might want that newest tech. We might want that car. We might want that new relationship. But I think a lot of the time, we get in the way of ourselves. We close those doors. We create this resistance. How can we begin to open those doors to allow more things to come through them? I'm going to talk about just a couple different things that can allow you to open the doors of opportunity and have the blessings flow into your life. So let's get into it. Now, the first thing is something simple. It's really just letting go of people and things that no longer serve you. Letting go of material things that no longer serve a purpose in your life. Each thing has a memory attached to it. Each thing creates and takes up some space, an energy, a meaning to it. You look at that item, you think of a certain person. You look at that item, you realize, man, I spent that much money on it. I don't even use it. You look at that object that's creating this, or that's taking up this space. When you feel good about letting something go and giving away something, you feel good of doing some spring cleaning and cleaning out the closet, getting rid of clothes that you don't wear. And that's going to allow you to make more room for new things. And it's going to be the same with people. How many relationships are you holding on to? For what reason? Does that relationship serve a purpose in your life? Positive or negative? What is it? Are they draining you of your energy versus charging you up? Can you hang out with this person and feel more energy and feel better about yourself, feel good about them? It's a mutual beneficial relationship. And by the end of that interaction, you just feel so happy, like, wow, I'm glad I met up with that person. Or are you holding on to relationships that when you go into the interaction, you feel social anxiety, you might feel judgment, you might feel not your best version of yourself? How many people are you holding on to just because you've known them for so long? If you let go of people and things, that's going to allow more things and new relationships to come into your life. So that's one thing. Another thing that can open the doors of opportunity, how can you receive more? And you can't just ask life with an empty cup. You can't just ask life, fill my cup. You must give value, give more, but you must do it with the purest intention. You must give without the expectation of receiving, that karmatic energy, that give and take. But you must fill your cup first. You can't just pour into other people and using up your energy and giving value without having value yourself. If you start doing that, then you start feeling drained and just like, ah, oh, man, where did all my energy go? You feel exhausted. But if you work on adding value to your life, working on your purpose, working on your passion, doing things that inspire you, that will overflow into the relationships around you. You'll be able to give and give and give and serve a purpose. And when you can contribute to a higher cause, a deeper meaning of life, life will reward you. But it needs to be with the purest intentions and the purest heart. You cannot give with an expectation to receive, because it doesn't work that way. Fill your cup first before you can run it over into others. Charge up first before you can charge up others. You can't have that ulterior motive. You can't give and say you owe me something. That's not a way to receive. You must sacrifice something in order to get something. The universe will reward you with the value that you bring into this reality. Like will attract like. Positivity will attract more positivity. So focus on bringing more value to yourself, to the marketplace, to this physical reality, and more value will return to you, without a doubt. Another thing, a third thing that you can do to open those doors for more blessings is to really sit in the present moment. Visualize as if you already have that thing. Feel the emotion of already obtaining that thing. Feeling that experience. And life will work itself out. You cannot express your lack to the universe. You cannot express your desire for that thing, because that means it's not in your current reality. You have to chase where it is. There's that resistance. But if you can let go of that resistance, let go of the desire, and already know that you will obtain this thing and you already have it, life will resonate with you and it will get pulled into your life, whether you know it or not. Everything in your current reality has been brought to you because of your past or current thoughts, whether we like it or not. So visualize that thing and express the gratitude that you have it. And that goes into the fourth thing that you can do to open the doors of more opportunity and blessings to come into your life. And that's gratitude. What are you grateful for? What do you have already that you can be grateful for? This body, this healthy body. I'm grateful for my family, these loving relationships that surround me. I'm grateful for food. I'm grateful for shelter. Now, when you have that, and you know you're grateful for those things that are unique to you, that gives you more to be grateful for. You start being grateful for the little things. Simplicity becomes a way of life. Have you ever had a grateful person or a fortunate person with an ungrateful attitude? No one likes that. Life will not reward you if you try to ask and ask for what you don't have and being ungrateful for what you do have. So if you can spend the first waking hours and the last waking hours of really expressing the deep gratitude of this gift that we have in this moment. Life becomes that gift. And every moment you cherish, then every moment's a new experience. You become curious. You become spontaneous and grateful for the uncertainty of life. And you're so grateful for the time that people invest in you. And you value yourself more. You value all the little things. And when you keep listing these things that you can be grateful for, the list will get longer. And the longer the list, the happier that you'll be. Now, the fifth and final thing that you can do to start opening the gate, start opening those doors of opportunity, opening the doors of positive manifestations, is detaching yourself from all the outcomes. Having no expectation on this life. I feel like the more that we try to control this life, the more resistance, the more blocks, the more confusion there is. And it starts to manifest things that we don't want in our life because we have this expectation of the result. Detaching yourself from the outcome of this relationship, detaching your outcome from where you're supposed to be in this current moment, where you're supposed to be in life. And I feel like if you let go of this control, things flow in and out of your life with no resistance. Then all of the other steps, all of the other things will align with itself. They'll work with each other. You'll be able to be grateful because you have no expectation to be disappointed. You'll be able to bring more value because you're not expecting receiving. And we are going to get in our own way, but that's okay. And I think if we implement these things more mindfully, but also giving ourselves grace and patience and giving yourself credit that you're moving forward and that you're making some progress. And that's it for today's video, to bring that full circle. Thank you guys again for being here. Thank you for your time. Again, it's all that we have and it does not exist, but we shall call it this gift. Thank you guys for being here, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.